Hey, curious people. So, for some time now, women have become a louder voice in the film industry, and therefore more productions appear, both on the small and large screens, with strong and brave and interesting female heroes. Do you remember the female version of the movie Ocean's 11, only with Sandra Bullock and Kate Blanchett? Or the female team of Ghostbusters, with Melissa McCarthy in the cast? Well, it probably won't surprise you that on TV, ladies are able to rock to the beat, fight, and do all the action sequences. This is the case with the series Killing Eve, which has become popular all over the world, and which will soon be returning to HBO Go. So check where it will be shown in your country, with the new season, of course. That is why today we will tell you all about the actress playing one of the main characters in this production, Sandra Oh. Who is she, and how did she gain fame? And why is the role of Eve Pilastri so important for her career? Stay with us till the very end to find out. But before you do, don't forget about the like and the subscription buttons. And did you know about our Instagram? Let's get ready, set, and go. In 2019, Sandra Oh was the biggest name during the entire Golden Globe Gala. Why? Well, we'll tell you about that later, because we have to start from the beginning, where the actress is and how she became famous. Sandra Oh was born on July 20th of 1971 in Nepean, Canada, as the daughter of a South Korean immigrant, the businessman father, and biochemist mother, who moved to that area about a decade earlier. Sandra has two siblings and was one of the very few Asian children in Nepean. At the age of four, her parents enrolled Sandra in ballet and acting classes to improve her pigeon-toed stance. And when the girl was 10 years old, she played her first role in the school performance. From her early years, Sandra was a hard-charging person, and in high school, she founded the environmental club, BASE, which basically fought against the use of styrofoam cups. She was also a student council president at the time. But mostly, Sandra loved acting. Knowing that she will never be as good a dancer to become a professional, she decided to focus on acting. So she continued drama classes, starred in school plays, and joined the drama and comedy club. Later, against her parents' will, Sandra rejected a four-year journalism scholarship to Carleton University and decided to study drama at the prestigious National Theatre School of Canada in Montreal, paying by herself. Sandra promised her parents to try acting for a few years and return to the university if it failed. But as we all know, that didn't happen, and that's why she says in interviews that she's the only person in her family without a master's degree in something. But still, her name is known worldwide. So after graduating, she played in a stage production of Dave Mamet's Oleana in London, Ontario. And what's more, she received two title roles in biographical television films of two significant female Chinese Canadians, while for one of them, she was chosen for over 1,000 candidates. Her performances were warmly received by critics and audiences. Since then, Sandra has divided her work between playing theaters, television, and movies, from episodes to larger roles. The most important productions include Bean, The Princess Diaries, Under the Toussaint Sun. Above all, Sideways, a film from actress's husband that won the hearts of viewers and critics, which had a budget of $19 million, earned over $109 million worldwide. Sandra Oh learned to ride a motorcycle, especially for this film, while the director and screenwriter, Alexander Payne, won numerous awards for it, including the Oscar for the Best Writing Adapted Screenplay. Sandra and Alexander met long before the film was made. They were dating for 3 years, and then they got married on January 1st of 2003. However, their marriage lasted only 2 years, and today none of them speak about this relationship. Besides, Sandra Oh is known for not saying anything about her private life. It's really hard to find any information other than what's related to her career. After the divorce, the actress only referred to the rumors about her love life and her relationship posted in TMZ. In an interview with Mary Claire, she said, "I don't listen to this stuff. I don't see it. I tell people I don't want to know about it because while rationally you might know it's ridiculous, it can hurt your feelings. It can knock me off from being my authentic self." And although the actress is silent in this topic, gossip media report that she's in a relationship with Andrew Featherston, the drummer of The Hereafter, but is this something serious? Anyways, Vipassana, a Buddhist form of meditation that the actress practices, cares for Sandra's healthy senses. The actress confessed, "It takes a long time to free oneself from chatter, goals, social media, image, and persona. And if you're able to move through it in that way, you can actually start trying to create a different place." So let's get back to the actress's career, because here came the year 2005, when Sandra Oh received the role for Christina Yang in the series Grey's Anatomy, which changed her life forever. ABC's production about a group of interns and later doctors working at the Seattle Grace Hospital who try to reconcile work and personal life has won the hearts of viewers around the world. Its cast has gained international fame and millions of fans overnight, and the series itself has won dozens of industry awards, and it's run for 16 seasons now. It's interesting how the actress, in general, won the role of Christina, who with time becomes the best friend of the main character, Meredith, and the one of the more charismatic, iconic characters of all in the production. Meanwhile, we almost wouldn't see a star in this role at all. Yes, we know it's really hard to imagine that now, but listen. Well, it turns out that on the day of the audition, Oh had a really hard day. She got a message from the agent at the last minute, left the phone at home, and even forgot her wallet. And at one point, although she arrived earlier, warmed up, and waited for tests, she found out that something was wrong and decided to leave and skip the audition. Fortunately, thanks to the fact that she caught up with the contact with the creator of the series, Shonda Rhimes, Sandra got the role, which she played for 10 years. Sandra Oh left the series in season 10 and broke her fans' hearts. Although for her, acting in it won numerous awards and distinctions, including the Golden Globe for Best Performance by an Actress in a Supporting Role in a Series, Miniseries, or Motion Picture Made for Television, or several Emmy Award nominations. The actress decided that she played this character long enough and it's time for new experiences in her career. Sandra has repeatedly emphasized that this was an extremely important production for her, but she felt that she had already given it everything she had. And apparently she had planned to leave the series in 2012, but for an emotional detachment, she needed 2 years in therapy, although the actress, known for keeping secrets, did not confirm it. Of course, the questions of whether there was a chance of her return or at least a guest appearance in the series never ends. Fans and journalists ask about it almost every time they talk to the actress, and she always has one of the same answers for them, which is no. In an interview with Variety, she said, "I'm going to say no. I've really got to try to create much more of that separation." And in addition, she said that now she has a new love, which is the character Eve Pilastri in the series Killing Eve. And it's thanks to this character that Sandra made history on American television. How is that? Well, I'm gonna tell you real soon. Killin' Eve is a BBC American production, and we will not say any spoilers, but it is a story about an MI5 agent bored with office work who secretly dreams of being a spy. One day, she gets a break of Villanelle, a psychotic and fearless, unscrupulous killer, addicted to luxurious life and adrenaline. Eve is tasked with tracking a woman, and so the exciting cat and mouse play begins. The series, for which the script was written by Phoebe Walker-Bridge, the author and star of another TV hit, Fleabag, was based on the books by Luke Jennings, who told the New York Post how the actress was sought for the main role. The author admitted that the producer's desire was for this character to be played by an American woman, but many of them were too fancy to play bored gray agent. It was supposed to be a character who's gotta go to work by bus, knows how to iron, and earns miserably, and she indefinitely not an elegant housewife. So when the name O dropped and everyone liked the idea, and according to the creators, the actress, apart from her excellent talent, has no vanity and is very funny. She matched the role perfectly. Sandra couldn't believe that she received a phone call to play in the series. Sandra has opened up on the subject for Variety magazine, and she admitted that knowing that the heroine was white in the book, when she checked the script, she was wondering which character would be proposed to her. Only when the agent assured her that she was to play the main role, she did understand how much she was soaked in the conviction that in the American film industry, such characters do not get the actors of another origin, regardless of their caliber. About her casting, she said, "It's taken me 30 years to get to this part. I see that so clearly as I continue to mature and be in this world. I really realize that change is excruciating slow, but I do feel like it bends toward justice. I've worked my whole life toward it and might not see the change in my lifetime." Actually, to see oneself as a thread in the tapestry of change, I think has more meaning. Well, viewers around the world liked the series, and Sandra Oh turned out to be a sensation at the Golden Globes Gala in 2019. Not only because she and Andy Samberg co-host the award ceremony of the Hollywood Foreign Press Association, but also because she won the statuette in the Best Performance by an Actress in the television series drama category. Both of these facts were historical because for the first time, the host of the show was by an actress of Asian descent. As well, she became the first Asian woman who won the award in this category for almost 40 years, and was the first Asian woman who won more than one Golden Globe. The touched star receiving the statuette ended her thank you speech by directing words of gratitude towards her parents. It turns out that they are the ones who are particularly excited about participation in the popular series. The actress mentioned that in Vanity Fair that there was this day when she drove with her mother and dad around the city until they found a huge billboard with a poster from the series and her on it. When they found it, her parents were very happy and proud. Sandra confessed that it was an extremely important event for her because it's not easy to make them feel that way. Having a sister as a lawyer and a geneticist brother, she finally reached this point of fame when they appreciated her as an artist. She stated, "Koreans are ambitious, man. It means a lot to my parents that I do the work that I do, and it has the visibility." According to Celebrity Net Worth, Sandra Oh's assets are estimated at $25 million. Her career is thriving, and we are just waiting for the third season of Killing Eve series, which premiere will take place on April 12th, and, like the previous ones, will have 8 episodes. Perhaps fans of the series will also enjoy the fact that there are also plans for the fourth edition of the production. Are you guys waiting for the third season of the series and the return of Sandra Oh and Jodie Comer in the roles of Eve and Villanelle? Do you miss the actress in Grey's Anatomy? And why do you like productions with her in them? Write it in the comments. And remember, you can put more than one answer. So remember to like this video and subscribe to the channel, as well as recommend this episode to your friends. See you soon!